you know, Funk Master Flex, man, is somebody I really was never fond of. You know what I'm saying? I always said that he was suspect to me in a lot of ways. You know, and going by this picture right here of him with the shifty eyes and all that stuff, you know, he's a real shady motherfucker. As y'all know, Funk Master Flex has been basically trying to, per se, trying to bring back the 90s, which, by the way, that was a great decade for me as well, you know. But his recent outburst of disrespecting one of the greatest hip hop rap icons ever, and the late great Tupac Shakur. By the way, his birthday is coming up on the 16th of next month. You know, the era of Gemini. Shout out to all my Geminis out there. You know, my biggest problem with that, and I'm not just saying this because I'm a Tupac fan, you know, and my brother Poppy Bay is a Tupac disciple. I'm a Tupac disciple myself, and I'm gonna tell you, but mostly on the political side. But my problem with him is, why would you want to go ahead and talk greasy about the man now when he's dead? It would have been a lot more credible if he would have said these things if he was alive. You know what I'm saying?
I go on and on, can't understand how it lasts so long. I must have superpowers.
I know that's Too Short playing in the background, blow the whistle, but this is a very special one. Just listen close to it while I come by dialogue on this. But Funk Master Flex had come up in the news about saying that Tupac shot himself in the leg when it came down to him being robbed at the studio and all this other stuff like that, you know. And Black Twitter took off and went in his ass real quick. If this ain't the biggest form of coonery I've ever seen in my life, this is it. Let me let y'all listen to this. Let that play in the background. While in the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and continue with this. But Funk Master Flex is straight. He is straight pussy for doing that shit. You know. But not only Black Twitter took off on his ass, but also recently T.I. got in his ass too. And I came across that article. As you can see right here. I'm gonna just get right into it right now. I'm gonna just let this. And like that. Now, Funk Master Flex is known. This is from when rap was real. So as you can see the article right here, T.I. gets real from Funk Master Flex. He sparked out, sparks outrage over Tupac shooting. Now T.I. to a degree, Tupac was influenced on him too. Now Funk Master Flex is known for speaking his mind on the radio, but this time he's probably gone too far. With the highly anticipated biopic of Tupac Shakur set to be released this summer, Funk Master Flex has a few things to say. Okay, let me stop there. That is coincidental. I am going to go watch it and stuff and so on, to see if they got everything right. So I'm definitely gonna do that. when it dropped. But at the same time, I'm like, it's ironic he goes ahead and start throwing shade at a man who's been dead for the past 20 years. You know, past 21 years, I'm sorry. So, according to BET, Flex decided to share his opinions of Tupac's infamous 1994 shooting, and no one is happy about what he has to say. Now, one rapper has shared his opinions of Flex's statement, T.I. Now, for all y'all Instagram warriors, you know May 4th, Tip took the Instagram with screenshots of Flex rant about Tupac shooting. With the photo, he included a response to the comments and offered Flex a few wise words of advice. Quote, yo, Funk Flex, respectfully, bro, on G Code, regardless of what you think the validity of your statements is, I was taught to never to speak down on a dead man, Tip said. Considering they ain't here to speak up for themselves, see, when he was alive, you was on the air then. That was the time to address this. Not here, not now, not like this. And I say the same to a nigga from LA speaking on Big. And that's real talk. Now this is Tip's Instagram page right here. That's his Instagram page. And see, this is what Funk Flex was talking greasy. I'll just go through it. Saying the beef was Pop got robbed because he did the wrong New York cats dirty. He was scared of them, so he blamed Biggie. And those were Pac's quote-unquote friends. Pac's been running with them and knew they were looking for him, which is why he had the pistol. And then he said again, 44 minutes later, the same friends that was with him when he caught the rape case. He been knew them niggas. Then he caught amnesia on the niggas that was holding them down when he came to New York. Classic case of out-of-town nigga wanting to be accepted and got in too deep and couldn't dig his way out. You want the truth? There it is. At the same time, now, as you can see, T.I. Flex Twitter rant, you know. My apologies. Hold on one second. Let me see what's up. All right, sorry about that. You know. Now, T.I.'s clapback following Funkmaster Flex Twitter. Those who missed it, Flex decided to give his take on the shoot. Well, I just read that. I think these are some of the other tweets. Oh, shit. Sorry. This thing. I think ever since I got that new update, this thing been acting a fool. But let me just go back on that real quick. But y'all see it like that. Funkmaster Flex is a coon. I'm not going to stay too long on this shit, though. Because I think that shit is greasy. It's dirty. It is that. You know what I'm saying? You don't go ahead and kick a man when they're down. And more importantly, you don't go ahead and throw shade at somebody when they're dead. Now, I wouldn't be surprised that something might end up happening to Funkmaster Flex. See, he think he doing some slick shit, but, you know, he ain't slick by a long shot. You know, because I never really did like him. I really never did like this motherfucker. But Funkmaster Flex, you a coon, man. Straight coon. Trying to do this shit for ratings. Like, you ain't gonna get far with that bullshit. You really not.